Now, what is classroom interaction? Interaction means exchange. Exchange from one to the other. And when it comes to classroom interaction, the exchange that happens in the classroom. So the term classroom interaction refers to the interaction between the teacher and the student, among the students, that happens in the classroom. If it is a kindergarten classroom, there will be interaction, but in different forms. If it is a graduate classroom, there will be interaction. So interaction is basic in teaching learning process. We know that. It can be between teacher and learner. It can be between learners, means students. It can be. Classroom interaction is two-way communication. Because there are two parties in the classroom. One is the teacher, other are the students. So it has to be and it should be two-way communication. In the traditional classrooms, there used to be one-way communication. But today we insist that students ask. Student participate in the discussion in the classroom. Teachers also motivate students to take part, get involved in the classroom. And if it is two-way communication, it will be very meaningful for the learners. It will be easy for the students to understand what the input is given by the student. And it will be easy for the teachers to understand the output of his input. Because how? You can ask the students if they have learned the concept or not. So you can understand the input and output and you can make your teaching meaningful if it is a two-way communication. It is basically classroom interaction. Whatever we talk in the classroom, whatever we do in the classroom, it is related to classroom interaction. It is a social interaction. So how classroom interaction is a social interaction? Because we feel that classroom is a miniature of society. Students from different caste, creed, area, socio-economic background come in a small classroom. So it's a small society. So it is a social interaction. Second thing, why it is social interaction? Because the interaction is related to developing relations, explaining others, understanding others. So it is in that way social. It is not anti-social. But this social interaction happens between the teacher and the students and among the students. And when you analyze this classroom interaction, it analyzes this relationship, how this relationship is between teacher and students and between students. Classroom interaction shows this. How the teacher is open-minded, how the students are freely expressing themselves, what language they are using. Classroom interaction is related to two skills, listening and speaking. Obviously, when teacher is speaking, students are listening, and students are speaking, teacher will be listening and others, his fellow students are listening. So classroom interaction is related measure to the speaking and listening skill. We are focusing on the speaking skill. Classroom interaction can happen in these four ways. Teacher to learners. Teacher to single learner or a group of learner. Single learner to single learner means one student is talking to the one student. and all the students are talking to all the students. So it can, classroom interaction can be in this four different types of nature, means who communicates with whom. So why there should be classroom interaction? What is the importance of classroom interaction? If there is no classroom interaction, there will be no teaching and no learning. It is impossible. So there must be classroom interaction. So how is it helpful to students? First, it improves the relationship between teacher and students. How? You just think that if students don't talk with teachers and teachers don't pay attention to students, will there be healthy relationship? Will students share any of their problems with the teachers? No. If teacher is not allowing the students, if they are not talking with each other, there will never develop a relationship. Talking develops relationship. Interaction develops the rapport. It helps students to develop thinking critically. Now, if teacher is teaching something and students don't ask anything, it will never develop their critical thinking. If they don't ask, if they don't discuss with their fellow students, their friends, you imagine that you don't discuss anything about classroom interaction, what your friends has said, what your teachers has said, you will never develop critical thinking, new ways of looking at things. It helps the learners to identify their own learning methods, sharing their views. Now, what is learning method? We know that different students learn differently. Now, if you don't discuss with the teacher, how will you find that this is how you learn? This is what you have learned. This is the correct method of learning for me. If you don't discuss with the teachers, how will teacher will know that you have not learned something? What are your mistakes? So classroom interactions help find your learning, correct learning method, and your mistakes as well. Then I told you it helps meaningful communication in the target language. What is target language? Means the language that is being taught. For example, if it is an English classroom and if there is classroom interaction, student will use the English language, the target language, that is English language, and they will start understanding. They will start having meaningful communication between teacher and students and student and students. They will start using the language if there is classroom interaction. Then they are not only learning to talk, they are also talking to learn. You understand this? When there is classroom interaction, students are also learning how to talk in English. And they are also learning how to learn through talking, through interaction, through discussion. So when you give opportunity to the students to speak in the classroom, you are actually giving them an opportunity to learn the language, to use the language, and also to take part in learning process. Then it increases their competency, means their ability of language, their capacities, their skills, their autonomy. What is autonomy? They feel free to express. They become self-learners. They become self-dependent. It will promote the rate of second language acquisition, means it will help them learn second language, that is English, as fast as possible through classroom interaction. The more they use the language in the classroom, the faster will be the acquisition, the acquiring process, the learning process of second language. The interaction motivates the students of their active engagement and participation in teaching. How? If interaction happens, students feel involved in the teaching learning process. They feel that they are part of the classroom. They become active. You know, when some students ask some questions, when some students add their answers, when students raise their hand, they automatically feel active, engaged in the classroom activity. When classroom interaction happens, learners have opportunity to share their ideas and also to learn from others working with them. When they get more involved, they feel more secured and their anxiety goes. They feel less stressed. They enjoy learning language. When you are freely sharing your ideas in the classroom, you will enjoy learning language. Doesn't matter how many mistakes you commit. So this is how classroom interaction is important in language learning or any classroom. Now, what activities can you do to promote classroom interaction, to increase classroom interaction, to develop classroom interaction, and to give opportunity to students to speak, to get involved in the classroom? First thing, you give collaborative learning activities. What is collaborative learning activities? In students need to ask others, students need to take help of others, students compulsorily need help from others. For example, if you give them project work in group, they have to talk to other students. If you don't give such activity, they will never talk to each other. You may make groups, whatever you like. You may make group of students in which one student is very active, one student is very passive, but in that group, the active students will help the passive students to be active. So group activities in which the activity is to be done in small groups, it is collaborative learning experience. Then in English, we have pair work and group work. Pair work means the work between two people, and group work is between more than two people. For example, a dialogue can be between two people, but a situation of a meeting in classroom can be a group work. So we have pair work in the form of dialogues. There are many exercises given in the textbooks that promote pair work. In pair work, one student might be asking question, other might be answering. One student might be a inquiry officer and the other student might be the traveler who is inquiring at the railway station. So there can be many situations in which pair work can be done. For example, one student is calling on the phone and other is receiving the phone and they are talking. This can be a pair work. This is the part of classroom interaction. Then we can have discussions and debates on some topic in classroom. All the time, teacher should not insist that he is the only person to speak in the classroom. He can have one lecture on one special period for discussion and debate. He can give very interesting topics in which students debate. Make two parts and they will debate a topic. Then we have interactive session. Interactive session means there is a topic in which we will interact with each other. We will exchange our ideas. That is interactive session. Interactive session can also be at the end of every lecture. Last 5 minutes, you should ask your students, let's have interactive session about the today's learning. Then we can have loud reading. What is loud reading? Reading loudly. All the class can listen. Loud reading is actually nothing but we are speaking the language, but by reading. Then we can have storytelling. Teacher can tell the stories and teacher can ask the students to retell the story in their own words. Teacher can just give points of the stories and students complete the stories in their own words. This promotes classroom interaction. Then we can have role play, very interesting. Role play of any profession, any individual can be done in the classroom. Then teacher should always talk with their learners, conversation between them, normal conversation outside the classroom and in the classroom. Then teacher can have many games, like guessing games. Guess what am I doing? Guess what am I behaving? Guess what is my acting? What am I enacting? So teachers can do these and many more activities to promote classroom interaction. I will show you a video. What is the role of teacher? At the end of this discussion, I will show you a video. How a teacher is interacting with their students. Very interesting video. What is the role of teacher? The teacher should promote meaningful communication in the target language, in the English language. Always have meaningful communication. Students should speak. Whatever is necessary in the teaching learning process. Students should not make unnecessary sentences or noise in the classroom, which is not meaningful for the learning, not meaningful for the classroom teaching. So you should promote that students should speak what is meaningful for them. They should not be allowed to speak anything. Then engage learners in tasks that deepen their experience and understanding of the target language. So you give them such tasks and such activities that help them learn the language. Talk with them informally. Formal talk is always there in the classroom, but talk them with informally. Say them, hi, how are you? What are you doing? What are your interests? What do you feel about this or that? What about your family? You can talk informally with students. Then greet students. I will show you this video. Even outside of school, in the classroom, you should greet the students in the extracurricular events or anywhere you meet your students, greet them. This will help. Then students will start talking with you. If you do this, you can single out few students each day, every day in the classroom or in the lunch room or anywhere. You should find a new student every day and talk with him. Greet each by name. You can take their names. Good morning, Saurabh. Good morning, Jairaj. Good morning, Krunal. Good morning, Sheetal. Yes. Greet everyone by name. Give them feedback. If they are talking with you, you tell them that you should talk like this. You should use this sentence. May I use your pen? You can use. You can correct them. If they are committing any mistake, you should correct them. This is how you promote classroom interaction. Encourage the students to use some common sentences. Give them a list of some common sentences. Some common sentences are asked for repetition. Can you please repeat? Asking for clarification. Making requests. May I come in? Asking for feedback. Asking for permission. Apologizing. Right? I have given the examples. When you ask somebody for repetition, you can say, can you please say that again? What was that again? Sorry, I didn't catch that. Pardon. Can you speak up, please? Can you speak a little louder? So these are the common sentences which should be given to the students, and they will use these students sentences. So you can give them some common sentences. There are some common sentences for permission. For example, may I come in, sir? May I come in, ma'am? May I open the book? May I read, sir? May I talk to you, sir? May I go outside, sir? Can I take a leave, sir? So there are many common sentences that are used in the classroom. So you can give them these sentences, list of the sentences, and they should use that.